jiggling out your jeans, baby, pull your pants up.
I like it when I see you do it better than I've ever seen it done before. A lot of women dropping to the ground, but how low can you go? Lower than your mama's ever seen it in a lifetime. Never would have imagined it, not even in her right mind. Practicing front of that mirror, now you doing it on the dance floor. Mad cause I can't get with your chick, just show me how to dance. Drop it, hit it, dump it, split it, don't stop. Put it in reverse, just to rack it up. Let me put some loot it, show me what you working with. I'll show you some of this bank roll. Yeah, you a superstar, there's just one thing I gotta know. So don't stop, don't stop.
Before we talk about how low the depth can go, let's talk about how low should the depth go. You see?
Okay, well, not all public debt is bad. Economists agree that borrowing up to 60% of GDP is actually sustainable. You know, if we borrow up to 60%, we can use, we can not only protect our citizens, we can also pay off the interest expenses without overcrowding out other good types of government spending.
The problem is when we start borrowing a lot more than that, which is the path the U.S. is currently on, with 72.8 public debt to GDP ratio predicted to grow at about 200% by 2040, when our generation is going to shoulder the burden, we could suffer the bulk of program costs, tax increases, and increased cost of borrowing for basic loans like mortgages and student aid. Having so much debt also decreases confidence in the U.S., which stagnates economic growth and hurts public morale. So, you see, how low can the debt go?
That's a good question. Well, the Center on Budget and Policy Priorities recommends a $1.5 trillion deficit reduction package split equally between higher revenues and budget cuts, which can be implemented over the next 10 years. Potentially, this would stabilize the debt at 73% of our GDP up until 2020. This amount of deficit reduction would represent a significant achievement, as it would take a crucial next step towards addressing our long-term budget problems, while giving policymakers more time to find effective ways to slow healthcare costs. Well, there are also two other plans. First, the bipartisan Simpson-Bowles plan and the Diminishin-Rivlin plan, which recommend a bigger $2.4 trillion package reduction package that would bring the debt below 70% of GDP in 2020.
Rising healthcare costs are what is driving the debt. To reform healthcare, we can look at government healthcare expenditure policy, but also at why healthcare costs are so high in the first place, and making the healthcare market more efficient and price transparent, which Time recently talked about in their cover story last week. So, my name is Kush, and I care about the debt because it is a big thing that's going to affect our future and future generations, so it's something we need to look into right now.
My name's UC. I care about the debt because I'm a student and I have loans, and I want future students to also be able to go to college and pursue education with loans.
I was in the 212 on the Uptown.